This good news is sponsored by Eddie Bussey of State Farm Insurance.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Local Living. I'm Anna Christina and it's time for our good news. I will say I'm starting off with a little more of a serious statistic this time, but only to be followed by some good news. But I want you to listen to this because it is very shocking. 1 in 10 people will be or experience sexual abuse by the time they're 18 years old. And typically, it's by someone that they know. And the good news is that the Child Enrichment Inc. is located here in Augusta to help provide resources and intervene. But our goal is to eliminate child abuse and sexual abuse. And joining me right now is Kari Viola-Brooke. She's the Executive Director of Child Enrichment here in Augusta. Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
So I know this is a little bit more of a serious topic than maybe our viewers are used to, but I think it's so important to talk about because so many people don't want to talk about it. And so I want to, you know, open up to the viewers what you guys do. What's your mission over at Child Enrichment?
Yeah, so at Child Enrichment, we work to provide interventions, mm-hmm. prevention, and stabilization for children who've experienced abuse. Mm-hmm. So we work with kids in our community between the ages of 3 to 17 on the Child Advocacy Center wow. side, and from birth to 18 on the CASA side.
Right. And so explain what that is, because I know you mentioned CAC and CASA, and some people may not be familiar with what that is. Can you break that down for us?
Sure. So CAC stands for Court-Appointed Special Advocates.
Okay.
And what that program does is they train community volunteers to get sworn in as CASA volunteers.
Okay.
And a judge will appoint them to a case when a child is brought into foster care.
Right.
And that CASA really works in the best interest of the child. Mm-hmm. So they'll meet with the child on a monthly basis, and they will write a report for the judge on what they think should happen with that child. And the goal is really to get some permanency for that child,
right.
get them a final place to live.
Some stabilization. And so talk to me about, you know, these kids, they're from this area.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's so important to point out because some people might think, oh, well, they're coming from out of town, but it's happening right here in our backyard. These children are from this area, and I think that's so important for you to grasp. And there's help that is still needed for these children, resources that need to be provided. Tell me about the pressing need from the CSRA.
So really some of the things we need is we really need monetary donations. We're a nonprofit in the community, so we get our funds through special events we do,
right.
donations from community members
exactly.
to provide these services for the kids that mm-hmm. live here. And then we also need volunteers. Like I explained, our CASA volunteers, we need people who are committed to working for the best
right.
interests of a child.
Right. And it's a tricky situation because I think that with other organizations, you know, it's easy to make the connection because the stories can be divulged, can be aired out.
Mm-hmm.
And in this case, you know, you're dealing with children. You know, you can't necessarily bring a child that has been abused to an event where people can actually make a personal connection. But that's what I want to stress is that it is happening. Even though you're not necessarily seeing and hearing these stories mm-hmm. firsthand from the child themselves, it's still happening.
Yeah, so on our Child Advocacy Center side, last year we served 536 kids.
Mm.
And what we do with that program is we are the ones that interview children when there's allegations of abuse.
Right.
So instead of them going to law enforcement or DFACS,
mm-hmm.
they come to the Child Advocacy Center and are
right.
trained by, well, they're interviewed by a trained professional.
Right.
And those interviews are videotaped. And then we follow up with the family with advocacy services and then free counseling services.
Right.
And overall, Child Enrichment served over 1,000 kids from our community here.
Wow. I mean, it should be shocking, I think, to people to hear that. And those are just the cases that you know of. So many kids are afraid to talk about this type of abuse. I mean, that's why you end up hearing later on in life where people come and they're finally able and capable to talk about these type of things. But again, it is happening. Where can people find more information if they are interested in helping? Where can they go?
Yeah, so people can go to our website, which is www.childenrichment.org,
okay.
or they can call us at 706-737-4631. 4631.
Okay, perfect.
And we also have a Facebook at Child Enrichment, Inc.
And one of the things that I want to point out, too, is that you do put on different events and things where people can come out and support. And so that information is going to be on the screen just in case people want to reach out to you. That would be the best way to do it.
Yeah, and like us on Facebook, we're always posting information on there. Also, contact us to get a tour. We do tours on Fridays and come and see the work we're doing.
Right, and that's also important so that people can put, you know, make that connection and see for themselves what it is that you're doing. And there's so much help that is needed. So, Kari, thank you for what you're doing right now, and I encourage you, the viewer, to help any way you can. There's so many ways that you can. Again, that information will be on your screen. Kari, thank you so much.
Thanks.